Welcome to Life Talks with Stephen Marshall.
You need watering. It's such a simple thing to do, water your plants. Just fill up your little watering can or grab the hose, and however you do it, water those thirsty little flowers and plants. Pam wanted a planter box hanging off of our back deck to put summer flowers in. So our friend Troy made the cedar dual planter box that straddles our deck railing. It's quite inventive and it looks pretty with all the flowers in full bloom. The interesting thing is those flowers really need to be watered once a day, especially in the heat of the summer. If they're not watered, I'm amazed at how quickly they become distressed and wilted. If we go more than a couple of days without water, they actually look burnt and close to dead. Water them and within hours they perk up so that you can almost hear their little voices. Thank you, thank you. We were dying from thirst and now we're celebrating in the sun. I remember this time when I was home alone for a weekend. Pam was gone on the road to do a women's conference. When our schedule takes us apart, I like to go the extra mile by tidying up the house, fix anything on the to-do list, and of course make sure that the household things get taken care of. That includes watering the plants. For several days, I kept watering this plant and noticed that it couldn't handle very much before the water leaked out of the bottom. When Pam got home, I pointed out this troubled little plant to her, only to find out it was fake. The joke was on me! Here's the truth, though. Fake things don't need the water of life. Religious people who are basically engaged in form but deny the true power of God don't need the water of life. The real planting of the Lord, true believers, need the daily watering of God produced by His living Word. My dear brother and sister in the Lord, you need a daily dose of God's Word because it is the water of life for your soul. John 7:37 says, quote, Jesus stood and He cried in a loud voice, If any man is thirsty, let him come unto Me and drink, end quote. Staying spiritually hydrated is a matter of life or death for you. We all need the watering that Jesus has to offer, not just once, but constantly. Your physical body needs hydration constantly to stay healthy and, yes, to stay alive. Water is essential for all life. How much more your spiritual being needs the spiritual equivalent of what is essential for life? God's Word. Jesus, who is the living Word of God, said this to His disciples in John 15, verse 7, quote, If you abide vitally united to Me, and My words remain in you, and continue to live in your hearts, ask whatever you will, and it shall be done for you, end quote. You require spiritual watering, hydration from heaven. You are the planting of the Lord. You're a God plant, and that means you need to remain vitally connected to His life. That happens by the hydration of God's Word in your soul. Remember, Jesus said if you're thirsty to come to Him, you do it. Let's pray the Word. Father God, You are the Creator of all life and You have called us to abide vitally united to Jesus. He is the Word of life and He is the water of life. You quench our thirst, but we need to stay spiritually hydrated so we've got something good to give to others. Isaiah 58 says that You continually satisfy our desire and that we are to be like a well-watered garden. Father, we honor You when we are fruitful, and that requires Your well of salvation actively feeding our soul. We commit to staying in Your Word, Father, the unfailing supply and strength for our growth. All glory and worship to You, Father. In Jesus' name, amen. Your health and wellness are so important to God. He deeply cares for you. We make these Life Talks for you, so remember to please share them with your family and friends. You matter to God so much, and you really matter to us. We'd love to hear from you. Reach out on our website at allnationschurch.ca, where you can find our phone number or email. God bless you.